Ginger. That's what you need. A mouthful of the good stuff and you'll see the back of any seasickness.
Thank you for your support, John. Don't suppose you actually brought any ginger?
No, I don't get seasick.
Terrific.
Don't worry, Sherry. We've almost arrived at Cordona. I can see land through the porthole.
So much for docking by tea time. The captain seemed more interested in his maids than in his maps.
Oh, he sure looked grumpy. Cheer up. We're back where we grew up. It's exciting. What's changed? What's the same?
Ugh. I'm starting to question whether the weeks-long journey was worth it. Traveling all this way, enduring this indignity simply to visit a grave. Even if it is my mother's.
Ah, that's just Mycroft's nonsense, still rattling around in your head. Try to forget what he said. I have.
I believe it was that this is a performative farce, a feeble excuse to avoid responsibilities, and that there was nothing to be gained from it.
You needed to do this. Enough of the self-pity and doubt. So we're a little late. What of it? We'll retire to the hotel and visit her in the morning. It'll be worth it.
Thank you, John.
And if you want to notify the captain's wife of his indiscretions, I will not stand in your way.
Oh, at last. I'm quite ready to get off this cursed boat.
Come on. We'll go together. Hey, Sherry, come on, catch up.
Yes, yes.
Sherlock, don't get lost in this huge garden. Follow the sound of my voice.
Welcome to Il Palazzo di Lusso, sir.
Welcome to Il Palazzo di Lusso, sir. We just need your signature. Would you kindly sign these papers, sir?
There you are.
Ah, Mr. Holmes. Yes, we have room 221 prepared for you. I see it was reserved for two people. Would you like a second key?
Oh, no. I think we'll stick together.
Very good. Rooms are upstairs, sir. Welcome to Cordona.
Hurry up, Sherlock. I want to see our room. I hope there's a balcony with a view.
I apologize, sir, but your room is not yet ready. Perhaps in the meantime you would like to relax in the foyer? Tonight the restaurant is offering a complimentary Marlin ceviche to all our guests.
Let's check what they have on offer. Let's check what they have on offer. Hey, Sherry, just our luck.
If seafood's not to your taste, everyone loves Benedict's batch. Our poached eggs with hollandaise sauce.
Hey, Sherry, just our luck.
A medium, John, haven't we been through this already?
Come on, it's not like we've got anything better to do.
Excuse me, sir, but I believe Mr. Galici's conducting his seance at the moment. Perhaps you'd care to have your portrait drawn while you wait?
Why?
Pardon me.
Why should I sit for a portrait?
Sir, it's art. It doesn't need a why. It is its own justification.
All things require justification, be they objects, systems, or beliefs.
How about art as the lens through which we see the truth of the world?
That's backward. Truth is not subjective and not complicated. It's just the truth. It either is or it isn't. You do not need a lens to see it, just an open mind.
Ha! Huh. That seems rather close-minded. Truth, like beauty, is in the eye of the beholder. So tell me, what do you see?
Mediocrity.
Come now, Sherry. What did he do to deserve that?
The servant mentioned ceviche at the bar, Sherry. You should grab us some, and I'll find us a table.
I'm starving.
If seafood's not to your taste, everyone loves Benedict's batch. Our poached eggs with hollandaise sauce.
Okay, time to check if John found us a nice table for the evening.
Sherry, I'm over here with my new Ursine companion.
Pardon, monsieur, but I am not in the mood to talk.
Cordona's even quieter than I remembered. It's going to be a long evening.
Ah, come now, Sherry. What say we amuse ourselves with a little game?
What were you thinking? Oh, promise me it isn't nonsense. After being cooped up on that boat, I am itching for activity.
No. As you can see, someone left a cane on our table. I simply thought you could identify its owner.
So it is nonsense. It'll take me a minute, John, at most.
Well then, you can deliver it to him as well.
Deliver it to him? Then what are the staff here for? Aesthetics?
Stubborn, Sherry. Too stubborn. You wanted something to do.
Slapping oneself in the face is also something to do. That doesn't make it worthwhile. But all right. Let me take a look.
No matter how long you stare at the stick, it's not going to walk itself to its owner. A
crest depicting a bulb of garlic in a meadow. Perhaps the Fielding family or Meadows. Or Craven, from the old English name, meaning garlic place. The hand grip is a head of a golden Javanese statue, probably stolen from a temple. The dents suggest it has been used as a bludgeon. The cane is made of ebony. It's worn uncared for and bears the scars of numerous hits. This cane is an expensive and ostentatious weapon. Its owner must be vain, volatile, and of noble English blood.
Take it with you, Sherry. Let's return it to its owner.
All right, I hope you noted down your observations in your casebook. But how are you going to find this nobleman?
The cane itself is not enough. I may have to ask other guests if they saw who was here.
Would you like a drink, sir? Would you like a drink, sir?
Can I ask you a question?
My dear fellow, you're talking to the right man.
Even with your keen senses, Sherry, I doubt you'll find the cane's owner on your first try.
And would you be confident enough to bet on it, my friend?
Why not? Let's see how good you really are.
Can I ask you a question?
My dear fellow, you're talking to the right man.
Hey, Sherry, don't we now have the perfect excuse to visit the séance?
I'm just going to give the cane to its owner. You will not persuade me to take part in this show.
Come on, if you hurry, perhaps we'll see the ghost.
This hotel, this island, it's full of thieves. First my cane, now the diamond. Take your hands off me! You even know who I am? Hey, boy! That's my cane!
I get that a lot. It's a very common design.
What? No, that's a custom-made...
A joke. A joke. It was left at my table in the restaurant. I thought it deserved to be returned.
Well, I'll be... It is rare to encounter a straight-fingered truepenny these days. What a gentleman. But I must ask, how did you know I was the rightful owner?
Simple deduction. Your cane told me everything I needed to know. I was after a strong, middle-aged man with a keen interest in adventure, noble blood, and affection for strong drink. And if one were to go further, one may even be able to extrapolate your name from your heraldic symbol, Lord Craven.
Marvelous. Simply marvelous. That's me, Lord Andrew Craven. You are the real medium. You hear that, Emma? Well, you found my cane. Perhaps you can locate my diamond, too. Yes, you should do it. It will be child's play for you, Mr.
Holmes. And if a child can do it, then I'm sure the local police can suffice.
The police? Why bother? I know this harlequin stole it. The only question is, where is it hidden? Fine. Give me my stick and I'll resolve the matter myself. This thief almost confessed after a single punch.
I suspect a beating may result in answers of questionable veracity. Fine. I shall spare you and he the trouble if you first answer me this. You insist the medium robbed you during the seance. But what occurred exactly?
Ah! It was a dirty trick. We were sitting here in the dark, chanting and holding hands, as expected. Then something began to appear from the medium, like a cloud or a bubble. The swindler called it ectoplasm.
Ah, yes. Common in the spiritualist trade, and quite the spectacle.
Indeed. Perhaps too much. My beloved Emma screamed in horror, and I stood to defend her, attacking that cursed ghost.
How brave.
But my hand hit nothing. The medium jumped away from me, and Emma fainted. I lit the candle, and the diamond was gone.
How does a priceless diamond become the subject of a seance? It is an unusual accoutrement.
Emma wished to speak with its former owners. My grandfather told us it belonged to a Raja, an Indian king.
So you were summoning long-dead Indian royalty, and, pray tell, you were expecting him to converse in English?
To be frank, Mr. Holmes, I don't believe in ghosts. But Emma was fascinated by the idea of meeting a real king, even a dead one.
Well, a crown is a crown. Can you describe the stone itself?
A yellow diamond, not less than 100 carats, and perfectly egg-shaped. There is not another like it.
Stay here, and don't touch anything. I'm going to investigate further.
Don't fret, I'll be keeping a close eye on this thief.
There are light traces of rouge on the edge of this wine glass. This must be the ectoplasm. Too bad there's not enough for a proper chemical analysis.
Ectoplasm?
Half a glass of foul blair scotch and the remains of a poor Larranaga cigar. What else does a gentleman need? This brooch is old and cheap, but the moth design has its charms. There are light traces of rouge on the edge of this wine glass. There are light traces of rouge on the edge of this wine glass.
Thank you for helping us resolve the situation, sir.
What happened here?
I don't know. The ghost. I summoned it as usual, but then it all went wrong. The lady screamed and pointed at Lord Craven. And there was a shadow. Such a mystical force. It terrified the lady. And it must have taken the diamond. Who else could have?
Do you feel the presence of any supernatural entities at the moment?
Are you joking, sir? My nose is broken, this maniac wants to kill me, and you're asking about the spirits?
I suppose this can wait. I will investigate, and the culprit will be identified.
But the stubborn brute Lord Craven blames me right now. As if I could do something like that. Perhaps you can reason with him? Please?
Was this covered on purpose?
Of course. It is very dangerous to leave a mirror exposed during a seance. The spirits may become enraged.
Or someone may notice the trick they should not see. Quite a display for the tremulous visitor.
How can you not love this stuff, Sherry? It adds so much atmosphere to the room.
Pale skin, quickened pulse, unsteady breathing. She's barely conscious. The feebleness of women.
Really, Sherry? Poor thing.
I love the ambiance.
Nice and creepy.
The diamond was placed on the table so that all participants could reach it.
Ah, seems like you're ready to delve into your mind palace, Sherry. I'm sure you'll make some good deductions.
seems there may have been an unexpected visitor outside the window.
Ah, I hope it was the ghost of the Raja.
This looks recent. A shoe with a broken heel will surely leave scratches. All right, John. Do you think a ghost could leave this footprint?
I'm reserving judgment. Use your keen eye to follow the trail.